Good evening. Thank you so much for attending the Hero's Journey. We're really excited to have you join us tonight. You've already met our hero, or our representation of the hero, starting from the base of the mountain and continuing their journey. Next in our program is Cerro y Nube by Eduardo Aguilar. This work is the first work by the DCUE to be performed as part of our Mexican Repertoire Initiative, which will be continued as part of the Mexican Symposium, the Symposium for Mexican Music and Art this spring, at which the DCUE will be performing no less than five world premieres by Mexican composers as part of a larger symposium with conversations and networking around supporting and elevating Mexican music and art. The next steps of that would be next fall. We'll be excited to be bringing international trumpet soloist and virtuoso Pacho Flores to join the DCUE in a concert where we'll be playing the American premiere of the trumpet concerto that Arturo Marquez wrote for him, as well as other programming. And then next winter, we'll be playing the world premiere of a concerto for drum set and wind ensemble by one of the most important composers in the Mexican contemporary scene, Enrico Chapella. And then finally, next spring or spring break, the DCUE will be embarking on a tour of Mexico where we'll, between Mexico City, Guadalajara, other locations, we'll be reconnecting with a lot of these artists that we've been working with over the previous year as part of our tour and trip. So we're really excited about everything coming up with that. This work, Cerro y Nube, translates as Mount and Cloud. And so the clouds kind of diffuse or disguise, cover up the peaks of the mountain, and at times clear and provide bits of clarity. Unfortunately, Eduardo is not able to be with us. He lives in Oaxaca, Mexico, but we're hopeful to connect with him next year on our tour. Following Cerro y Nube, we have Journeys 3, composed by Quinn Mason. This is the winning selection of or the DCUE Special Selection Prize winning selection from our 2020 Composition Competition. So out of 248 submissions, this was the work chosen by the student members of the DCUE as their winning choice. We're very honored and fortunate to be premiering this work tonight. Composer Quinn Mason's star has continued to rise and shine and grow in the 2 years since submitting this work, with many commissions and guest appearances and performances by significant orchestras and arts organizations around the world. Our students have had an opportunity to work a little bit with Quinn over the last couple of days, and I'm confident you're going to love this piece as much as we do. Both of these works, Cerro y Nube and Journeys 3, are made possible because of the Scott Smedinghoff Memorial Fund. Scott was the pianist with the DCUE at the time of his passing, and this fund allows us, it facilitates the creation of repertoire that incorporates the piano into the wind ensemble. Scott's parents, Linda and Jim, are with us tonight, and we're honored to perform these pieces in his memory. So thank you so much, Linda and Jim. And just to save me from having to talk again, because this is my least favorite part of the concert, I'd like to draw your attention that in the second half, the two selections will be played a taka, or without pause, between them. So there'll be no break between the two selections, just to avoid confusion. But without further ado, let's continue the journey. Thank you.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.